Finally, let's look at an example of a modern anesthesia machine. This is the front part of the anesthesia machine. This is how it looks like in reality. And basically, if you look at these different parts, we have flow meters right there. These are the flow meters where the mixing of oxygen and nitrous oxide is done, and basically where we measure the flow rates of both oxygen and nitrous oxide. We have the vaporizers are right there. You have the display for monitoring the different parameters of the device right there. We have the breathing circuit that comes out of this part here. This is a ventilator part where actually the patient is connected through the breathing circuit to this part right there. And basically, the doctor will simply just adjust the flow meters, adjust the vaporizers, and basically make sure that the breathing gas is in order by looking at this display right there, just to make sure that that the parameters of the device is as programmed. If you look at the backside of the same machine, you'll find that the connections of gas cylinders is there. So basically you put the gas cylinders right there and connect them to the gas inlets. And basically we have the electricity in and out, the basic electricity coming in, and basically you have several outlets if you want to connect other devices. And this is very much it. And basically you might have also the scavenging connector where you can connect to the either the vacuum or the ventilation duct of the operating room to make sure that the air coming out of the anesthesia machine is not vented through the operating room atmosphere. It's actually coming out through the scavenging connector to the either the vacuum or the ventilation duct to be taken outside of the operating room.